we could be called mad for thinking that we can start up a new innovation zone in this part of London. But we've done it here, so why can't we do it again? I'm Alice Sewell, Investment Director at Imperial College London. Imperial College London is a global top 10 institution focused on STEM-B activity, which is science, technology, engineering, medicine and business. We've been investors in Old Oak since 2014, and the investment case there has been focused around the transport connectivity that's coming at Old Oak Common Station. So One Portal Way at the moment very much represents what the old world of Old Oak was: low density, sprawling workplace that's unfit for modern use. But what we saw was a real opportunity to change that. And because of the policies that have been centred around HS2's station at Old Oak Common, we were able to produce, you know, a very large master plan, 2 million square feet, 1,300 homes.
Fred.
Alice, how nice to see you.
We've been working with the visionary Fred Pilbrow from Pilbrow and Partners for a number of years and secured this really exciting master plan.
Today we have a horrible blank concrete wall, a pretty desolate space. And in fact, where we're standing right now, you'll see a square connecting through to a new park, which
exactly.
I guess is the heart of our scheme.
And we're just going past here, Fred, aren't we? The really interesting building that could be student accommodation or co-living. And I think that's quite exciting for us as an institution. It's providing accommodation for either our student community or the next innovators, you know, young professionals working in West London.
And I guess that kind of mix of uses is really central to the approach Imperial have taken to the scheme. It's really creating a whole new urban neighbourhood based around the college's core academic mission.
I think with Victoria Industrial Estate, although it's a long-term project and our ambitions are really long-term in terms of the wider global innovation district ambitions, we are looking at doing immediate change to activity on those sites and in Old Oak. So our meanwhile strategy is critical to what we're doing, and we're hoping to see live activity over the next couple of months from science innovation tenants. We released a new strategy in February last year, and a key pillar within that is the West Tech Corridor strategy. It's a unashamedly ambitious strategy around transforming West London into a globally competitive innovation district. So this is hugely challenging, but what we feel is, as an institution, we can lead this vision, bringing along partners and deliver it over the long term. I've been working in Old Oak for about 5 years, and even within that time, we've seen extraordinary change on the ground in terms of artwork popping up or looking up to the sky and seeing buildings flying up through modular construction, flats being occupied. It's really exciting. And I think for the next steps for us is to see that science innovation activity come forward.